In this video, I'll cover creating a terrain perimeter. When I work with terrain or site plans, I typically like to make sure that my layers and my plan view are set on the plot plan. To do that, I'm going to drop down the Save Plan View dialog, and I'm going to come down and I'm going to change my view to the plot plan. This way, as I create different elements for the site and terrain perimeter, it will come in on relevant layers. The next thing I like to do is change my toolbar configuration over to using the terrain configuration. This will switch the toolbar over to the terrain configuration. To create the terrain perimeter, I'm going to come over on the left-hand side of my menu system under Terrain Tools. A terrain perimeter can be created on any floor, and you can only create one terrain perimeter for your plan. Currently, I'm on floor 1. Typically, I will create the terrain perimeter. Maybe if I have a walkout basement, I might create that on floor 0. Most of the time, I'm going to be creating that on the main floor or floor 1. To create the terrain perimeter, I'm going to click the tool and it will generate the terrain perimeter as a rectangle, typically around your structure. However, you don't necessarily need a structure to create the terrain perimeter. The terrain perimeter is a CAD object, also known as a polyline. You can click on this, you can resize it, you can click on the dimensions, you can enter in dimensions for these, and really shape this in any way that you need to. A lot of times you might trace a terrain or import a DWG of a terrain, but this is just simply a polyline object that you can easily resize. I'm going to take this bottom segment for the lot boundary. I'm going to use the tool in the bottom, change line to arc, to create a slight curvature on the bottom. And at this point, I've created a terrain, and you can see this in your 3D view by coming in, and I'm going to use a perspective full overview camera. Program has created a flat terrain, and the height of the terrain with respect to the subfloor is set to be automatic. Let's move back over into the floor plan view and dimension the terrain with respect to the footprint of the house. Typically, I like to move the terrain around the house and not move the house around the terrain. Since there are so many different objects that may be in the house, I don't want to have to move all of those different objects. With the dimension tool, I'm going to use the point-to-point dimension tool, since this will dimension to arcs as well as off-angle lines, both of which we have in the terrain perimeter. With the point-to-point dimension tool, let's zoom in a little bit. I'm going to click on the edge of the wall and move over to the terrain perimeter. Then I'm going to select the terrain perimeter. I'll click on the dimension. I'm going to enter the value that I want to move the terrain. I'm going to change the dimension to move object. That way, it will move the terrain, the entire terrain, around the house. Now, when you have a terrain perimeter with a curve or off angle, as we do on the bottom and the side, the point-to-point dimension will allow you to easily dimension to those objects. Using the point-to-point dimension, I'm going to come over and I'm going to click on the wall, move over until I get a snap on the angle. And we'll do the same thing on the front, using the point-to-point dimension, come down, pick up the point, and then to move the terrain, I'm going to click on the point, I'm going to hold my shift key down and grab the terrain perimeter, come over onto the dimension, and I'm going to just enter that in as exactly 40 feet. Then I'm going to press F6 on my keyboard to fill the screen. You can see that the terrain perimeter has been positioned around the house, and I've also created the dimensions. That wraps up this video on creating a terrain perimeter. We have several other videos on terrain and site plans. Please see those in the video playlist as well as the built-in help file. Thanks for watching.